Hey, there we go.
Serverside development and
rock and roll.
Hi, everyone.
Hello.
Hi.
Hi.
Morning, everyone.
Hi, guys.
Hi, everyone.
Hello. Hi, everybody.
Hi, everyone.
My turn to talk now.
Okay.
Time for software.
Can you hear me?
I'm going to start.
All right.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you. That's it.
My name is Eyal. I'm a system architect of a product named StormRunner Load. From who know the Load Runner tool, so it is the natural successor of it. But when I first been asked to talk about this product, and knowing I have only half an hour, I decided not to do some kind of a marketing. Tool because a marketing presentation, because I guess if someone from you would like to have a performance testing tool, you will find your way. And when I thought it over, even a technical presentation won't fit into 30 minutes. I guess any YouTube short film can do it better. So what will we do? I will try to tell you a story. The story behind what we did, not technically, but how we chose our technology and why. I will begin with a short explanation of what the program does in order for you to understand where we came from by trying to choose what we decided. So it's a performance testing tool. Load Runner exists for about 20 years. Performance is about optimization. Optimization is a great field because, first of all, things need to work, and only then work better. So you never can stop doing better and better all the time, and it's very challenging. So we built a very simple tool which one can create a load test very easily. It's very smart because we implemented a few algorithms of anomaly detection and root cause analysis. That once your application experiences some problem, we are trying to identify it, and it's scalable. I'm sorry about the resolution because we just moved to a Mac. It's very scalable because we can launch up to 2 million virtual users within seconds. Minutes, not seconds. Okay, what does this tool do? You can see here at the bottom the few technologies we are using. One can create a script that simulates a real user, a real browser. He then can upload the script and distributed it all over the globe on different locations on AWS and the Azure cloud vendor. We also support the Rackspace in London and a few others. But basically, you can run your test from all over the places, all over the world. How it works, I'm moving fast because it's not my interest to drill down. So you create a test, you launch isolation lab within one of the cloud vendor, you attack your application, doing stress on it, then measure the results, and you can show result online. This is the tool. It's here for about 2 decades. The previous version of it, but the cloud and the ability we have now to provision hundreds of machines bring us to a next level of high performance computing, basically. And we run about 1,000 machines parallel for large tests. So, okay. I wanted to give a short demo, but maybe later I'll skip it. Do you see something? I don't know. Okay. So what the story I was about to tell you. We were about 5 people inside the organization. HP Software is the largest organization, enterprise organization, very heavy, very slow in motion, doesn't like, you know, to jeopardize its asset. And we were 5 people trying to change it. So we wanted to build the next level of Load Runner, the next step of LoadRunner using new kind of technologies and using what the infrastructure of the cloud has provided us. So we wanted to build a multi-tenant application, pure SaaS application. We wanted to support standards like OpenStack, and the light is here. We wanted to contribute to the open source community as well. We wanted to integrate with everything that there is, JMeter and Rackspace, and JMeter and the New Relic, and a few kinds of technologies that wasn't part of our usual environment. We wanted it to be very scalable, network intensive, data intensive. We wanted to move fast, and you were missing the last part. We wanted to enjoy it. We were 5 people. So what technologies we had in mind? It was about 2 years ago when we just started, and we hesitated because these days when you come to open, to write a new web application, you have few choices. First of all was the Java. I'll just put them all there. We had Ruby on Rails. There used to be a Play framework. I don't know if you're familiar with it. Google Go then started, and Node.js was the last one. So most of our organization writes its code in Java. We have about 1,300 developers in the HP site. 90% of them write Java. We didn't want it. Those 5 people, I was in charge of them. We didn't want to run Java. I'm not trying to tell you what is right, what is wrong. I just want to tell you what we decided. We have nothing against Java. We have a lot of things against how people write code in Java. The level of abstraction, the level of over-engineering, the fact that you, for an editor, need to spend 1.5 giga, it's not suitable for us. So we decided to give up Java very fast. Ruby on Rails was an option, but it felt old. I don't know why, I'm not young, but it felt old for us. So we gave it away immediately. So basically we considered 2 of the top technologies, which is Play framework, which was promising back then. It uses Scala and Java. And again, we didn't want to get into the JDK, JVM world. And at the end, we considered 2 technologies. They are both new technologies. And we were, as I mentioned, within an organization which was very difficult to embed new technologies. So we hesitated and we chose Node.js. I will give a word about Go later on. And instead of trying to tell you why did we choose Node.js, I don't know if you see it. Too much lights. I will try to explain what we expected it to be. And I guess this is some kind of the criteria we were putting on the table. We wanted code sharing between the client and the server. We were a small number of people doing the next level of a 20 years old application that hundreds of engineers worked on it. We were 5. We wanted to share. Wanted to share code between client and server and being able to be flexible by moving pieces of logic from the client server to the client side, to the server side, and the opposite. What do you think was the reality regarding this? Did we succeed? We used Node.js, JavaScript at the client side, at the server side. Did we manage to exchange pieces of logic between client and server upon demand? No, absolutely no. Again, I'm not telling it cannot be done. I'm telling you our experience. Whoever tells you that using Node.js will help you share code between client and server, it just doesn't work. It didn't work for us. The next thing we wanted to tackle was the people diversity. Again, 5 people. We wanted many people to do both client and server using the same technology, it's JavaScript. Did we succeed on this? Again, no. Unfortunately, and it's very common now when you see on the LinkedIn, I want an end-to-end developer, a full-stack developer, all this stuff. Personally, we don't believe in it. Because you can get a full-stack developer, it's going to be medium in one of the side. Is a medium developer on the client or medium developer on the server? They can hardly be expert on both of them. Again, sorry, my experience. Not if there's a very good developer on both sides, it's great for you. Our experience, client-side technology, is totally different. It's different kind of people. Again, server-side, it's different type of expertise, and it just didn't work for us. Development velocity, using JavaScript, we developed very fast. I must admit, we developed very fast. It's a nice language with many functional paradigms, which we really enjoyed in writing it, and we moved very fast. Two issues that are relating to lack of type system, JavaScript is the dynamic language, and two aspects we tackled was maintenance and quality penalty. First of all, maintenance-wise, it's problematic. The lack of type system for an application that scales in the number of line of code, it's problematic. And if you stand in front of such a decision, you should remember this. It's very easy to write code. It's very difficult to read the code. Okay, so we paid price in the maintenance. We are still paying. Regarding a quality penalty, because the lack of compiler, what do you think? Did we pay the? Okay, great. This is our methodology as well. The solution for quality is not a compiler; it's testing. Okay, a compiler might help, but it's not a solution. Okay, you never count on the compiler to find your defects, as far as we are concerned. Regarding tool chain, debugger, profiler, stuff like this, it's not yet mature. You won't be able to get your profiling tool and debugger tool like in .NET environment or Java environment and things like that. Performance-wise, it was a very good decision. It even did better than our expectation. We are a very tuned application. We handled tons of connections and much traffic goes over our servers, and it really helped us doing it. So this is a few of the technology being used within our product. We have RabbitMQ as a messaging system. We have Node.js with the Express middleware, AngularJS on the client, PostgreSQL as the database, etc. Okay, so what I wanted to express here is what were the candidates for choosing this technology. Because when you come to develop a new product, the level of the choices you have is enormous. And how you will choose it is basically, is a gut feeling, because I guess we could do it, we can accomplish it in Java, we can accomplish it in .NET, whatever, in Ruby, whatever we decided, and it just felt right to do some new stuff. Now, were we right? I really don't know, because now we are considering Go, for instance, because the two main concerns for people sharing and code sharing wasn't met with the Node.js, so we might now consider Google Go for some parts in order to take much better maintenance capabilities than Node.js. So I can't tell you it's the best choice. I can't tell you it is the worst choice. It just worked for us. And if you are in front of such a decision, take this under consideration. I'll be happy if you talk with us, if you have some more questions. And we always believe, we are now about 40 people, but you know there's a famous sentence in computer science, do what you know and know what you are doing. We would add it to enjoy, because we started as five, we're really enjoying ourselves. I didn't put you into the demo, because I don't have time, but it's I really encourage you to look for StormRunner Load, and it's a very impressive application, very technological one, very inspiring, and really enjoyed doing it. Thank you very much.